Hey guys, thanks for waiting. I know it was a long night without very much activity after the 14th pick. We'll let Trajan really address the player part of this. I think the thing we're the most excited about is, again, just the fit with us in terms of the human being. He definitely understands who he is. He takes pride in what gets him on the court, and he understands what his game really is. But I think the winning nature of his background and the way he approaches the game really fit well with us. I know our coaching staff was excited when they saw him in the workout. But overall, a really good night for us.
Yeah, very, very excited. Obviously, a kid with, I should say a young man with a big-time basketball background playing at DeMatha, and then a couple years at UConn winning a championship, and the jump from his freshman to sophomore year, not only in terms of the way he played, but his production and efficiency on the court with, you know, I think going from, what, 5 or 6 points to 16 a game and then winning a national championship was very attractive. And like Griff said, I think he'll be a great fit here.
What was just the contact with him like in the pre-draft process, and the interaction with him, you know, in the months and weeks leading up to the draft?
Yeah, I mean, he came in here for a workout, worked out really, really well. Like Griff said, he really connected with our coaches and taking stuff off the board, put him through sets, his speed off of down screen actions and his ability to get into shots quickly, all kind of different variety of shots, whether it's transition, half court, spotting up, quick first step, great read react on drives. So all of that complements, you know, our group of guys on the roster right now. And I think a lot of our players are excited about his skill set, what he'll bring. Obviously, the shooting component is huge and will be a huge addition for our team this year. But I think just as he's a high basketball IQ player, obviously a winner and a big-time competitor, so he'll be a really good fit with our group.
How valuable is it to have a guy like him who can move off the ball, run off screens, and create shots in that way?
Well, you're talking to somebody who did it for a long time, so I know exactly how valuable that can be. I think it does. It helps winning. It creates another source of offense. On our team, we don't have anybody like that who just comes off, and his shot variety, I think, is one thing that we really looked at in him. His shot profile, I think, was as unique as a shot profile in a shooter as you're going to find in college basketball this season. So it's not only his shooting prowess, but also his profile and his ways to get into shots all over the basketball court, which will be huge for us this season. Whether it's transition, whether it's coming off ball screens, whether it's coming off staggers, flare screens, just anything that you can think of, you can do that a lot in the mid-range, but to do it from that distance is really hard to do, and at the speed at which he comes off that, he has to engage defenses, which opens up a lot of other things. So when you have a Brandon, you have a CJ, you have a Zion, you have a Jonas, then you have this guy who can really shoot, running off a lot of stuff that players have to stay connected to where they can't help. On those elite type players, it opens up the floor for either our players to get something, or if somebody helps, then a player like that is wide open for, you know, wide open shots, which will help our offense. So very, very intriguing for us with the roster that we have, and very intriguing for our coaches as well to have another weapon on the floor with those guys.
Yeah, for the past few years, you guys have been able to find value, whether it be through undrafted or through the draft, finding guys who have a few years of college experience. How much
Yeah, it's worked well for us so far. Hopefully it'll work well again. But, you know, Jordan's a little older. He's 21 years old, so he's not an 18, 19-year-old coming in here. And Coach Hurley's tough. He's tough on his players. So he has some experience playing in high-level basketball games with very good players and playing for a tough coach who's very demanding. So he's going to step in here seasoned and ready and playing in front of the bright lights and playing big-time basketball when it matters. I personally saw him probably in his worst two games of the season, but that didn't detract from what he has done the whole year. He has had a phenomenal year, and again, from what he's done his freshman year to the leap as a sophomore year, just shows you how quick he learns the game and how quick he figures it out. So we're looking forward to him doing the same thing here.
He's also got experience doing exactly at UConn what he would do with us. You know, they won a national championship with a really non-traditional point guard situation. Andre Jackson, who was also drafted tonight, was not a shooter, scorer, point guard type, but he was a really smart player, and they ran a lot of their offense with him making those decisions. And Jordan's ability to create offense enabled them to have a player who can create offense while not being ball dominant. And we think the fit of that is really important with the group we have, because as you know, when we had injury situations, we needed somebody who could create offense. But when we were healthy, we didn't need somebody who needed the ball. So this gives us a unique kind of swing at both sides of it.
How important was it to find somebody that maybe you think could contribute now, so maybe having them go through a developmental year or two?
I think we have a pretty good roster when healthy. So he's going to have to beat some people out to play. But I think it's not going to take him too long with his basketball IQ, with his ability to be coached, and with the winning mindset, he's won at a high level. He knows what it takes. So, coming in here and the coaches, whatever they ask of him, he's going to be ready to do. So just that right there, and his maturity as a young man, everything. He's a pro already in terms of his mindset and his approach. So that's not going to take him long to figure out. But you know, the speed of the game, the physicality, the verbiage, all that is always there's a transition period, but he's going to pick it up quick. And I think the fact that he is a little bit older bodes well for us and was intriguing for us.
How different do you guys anticipate the roster looking now, you know, versus when we come into training camp here in September?
I think we can talk about that in another couple weeks with free agency upcoming. But we're going to start that. We're going to start talking about that on Monday. But I don't foresee a whole lot of change between now and then. I think we're happy with our roster the way it's set. I think the addition of Jordan is huge for us. I think we have a lot of good pieces that we're excited about having right now. How about keeping?
We came in at the off season, and I've talked to many of you about this already. We came into the off season, and we may have even said this when our season ended, looking for rim protection and shooting. And we feel like we've certainly addressed part of that tonight. But I think as we go through, if we're able to do anything to address that other portion, we would. But as he said, we're pretty comfortable with the group we have as well. We understand it's not enough to just say we will be healthy, but we're comfortable that we've got a group as we sit now that's pretty competitive.
Yeah, I think the fact that he did get him, he hunted him. But he hunted him the right way. There weren't many that he took that were bad. But you could tell that was what his teammates and what his coaching staff wanted him to do. So, again, whether it was transition, whether it was guy closing out with his hands down, whether it was coming off action, he was always moving without the ball, coming off actions or back cutting. That is going to be important for us to draw defenses away from some of our premier offensive players that are on the floor, and I think that will help. But getting shots up, we need him to make them too. So that's going to be important more than anything. And again, that's going to be what gets him on the floor, is he's going to get him up. But I think our teammates and his teammates and his coaching staff have to be they have to be secure that he's going to knock them down as well. So that's going to be the transition period. I mean, the game at this level is just so much more intense. It takes so much more out of you. You got to work so much harder to get open. So making that leap is there's always a transition period, but with the way the kid works and just the person, the high character that he is, I think he's going to fit in very well, and it's not going to take him too long to figure it out.
We've seen you guys move up and down the draft board before. Did you feel like you were close to making moves at any point tonight?
Not really. I think we were pleased Jordan was there when we picked. We had some conversations in the second round about maybe getting in, but the nature of the new CBA makes it so those picks are more and more valuable than they've ever been, so it was a little more difficult to do. And then once you get past a certain point, it doesn't make a lot of sense anymore. But I wouldn't think we were close to much of anything, no. Awesome.
Thanks, guys.
Thank you.